On Sunday, October the 3rd, a report of nearly 12 million leaked documents was published by the International Consortium of Investigative Journalists.
This involves 600 journalists from 150 media outlets in 117 countries.
This report is being called the Pandora Papers.
This report is yet another stunning leak of financial secrets.
If you're the type of person that likes these short and on-point updates with no filler content, subscribe to our channel to stay informed on what really matters.
In order to understand the magnitude of this leak, let's see some of the numbers that show exactly how big it is.
We have data coming from 14 sources, and there's a total of almost 3 terabytes of data, including
6.4 million documents, almost 3 million images, 1.2 million emails, 100,000 of spreadsheets, and other documents.
What we see from this massive data is that taxes are rising for ordinary people, and yet there's a sort of elite class who use clever offshore structures to hide their money.
The files allegedly expose the secret financial affairs of a range of global figures, including 35 current and former world leaders, and more than 330 politicians and public officials in 91 countries and territories.
So far, some of the most prominent reveals include
the King of Jordan's $95 million spending spree on properties in the UK and US through secretly owned companies.
Azerbaijan leading families' hidden involvement in property deals in the UK worth more than $540 million.
The Czech Prime Minister's failure to declare an offshore investment company used to purchase 2 French villas for $16 million.
The family of Kenyan President Uhuru Kenyatta owning a network of offshore companies for decades.
For years, this kind of money was stashed away in tax haven countries such as Panama, Belize, the Virgin Islands. But in recent years, the United States, through some very liberal laws in places like Alaska, South Dakota, Nevada, and Delaware, has become the go-to tax havens for global clients.
If you want to protect your money, Sioux Falls in South Dakota has become the place to go. Trust companies here are managing billions of dollars in assets for customers all over the world.
For example, a single building in South Dakota manages $100 billion in assets from foreign millionaires and billionaires, including some who have been accused in their home countries of fraud, bribery, human rights abuse, and other wrongdoings, either personally or through their companies.
Tax havens in of themselves are legal, but tax havens have been used over the years for illegal purposes, for hiding money from authorities, avoiding taxes that are owed, parking illicit gains from white-collar crime, or for politicians to disguise corruption payments.
So, while it may not be illegal in every case, it's highly problematic in terms of ethics, and it's highly problematic in terms of the growing rift of inequality that we see around the world.
It's clear now more than ever that we live in a world built on a sort of two-tier system, one for the ordinary, who play by the rules,
and another for the wealthy, who sometimes legally, sometimes illegally, essentially cheat by hiding their wealth.
The Pandora Papers leak is an ongoing story and we'll follow it closely as it develops. We hope this new leak will have an even greater impact than the Panama Papers had back in 2017.
We're glad to see that even after 5 years, the Panama Papers still have a big impact on politics, business, and academia.
With authorities in Malta charging the former prime minister's chief of staff with money laundering and fraud, Denmark boosting its fight against tax fraud,
while in the US, lawmakers cited the Panama Papers to support the push to enact 2 landmark pieces of legislation before Congress.
The Stop Tax Haven Abuse Act and the For the People Act, a voting rights bill that's being called the boldest democracy reform since Watergate.
That's it for today. Let us know where you keep your offshore money stashed away in the comment section below.
And subscribe to our channel to help us grow and reach more and more people.